It's March 14th. It's Monday. It's like 10 after 3 a.m. in the morning. I'm having dreams. I hope my sons are okay. I'm gonna go to school. They towed my RV again. During spring break. I contacted my son. I asked him to come over and help clean and save the house that Uncle Jimmy died in, or well, he lived in, and then he died in 2018, December 18th, 2018. And I told him, I said he could own it, but the city left a notice on it. And told him, to notice the board and inhabitable unless they clean it. And it's got, nice stuff in it, and I thought maybe they would keep it, because of their family. It's the last of their family. There's the baby of the family, and his picture was on the refrigerator, and so I took the picture. It's the only one that I have. But anyway, I was hoping that he could get a hold of his brothers and have him come over here and help me clean the house, and we could live in it rather than to be homeless and let the city have it, because there's nothing really wrong. It's got a brand new roof on it. But it needs a lot of work. But it can, it's livable. I could live in it if as long as they clean it. Well, I don't know if they got a hold of him or not. I'm not sure if my sons talk to each other or not. Their dads like to play games, so I don't know. Whoever keeps taking my RV is doing it illegally, because it's on private property and it's insured. And nobody contacted me, which I talked to the tow companies and told them, because they're not allowed to tow it and then tell me it's a civil matter, and then the police can't order them to give it back to me. I mean, I had to pay another, about $400 to get it back. That's $800 that I've spent on tow bills. And I said it's, uninhabitable, but I'm getting it fixed. This needs a tire and ignition. And I don't have anybody to help me fix it. But I luckily met a mechanic. That's not a coincidence. That's on purpose. I hope nothing comes up stolen. I mean, I'm not saying he's a thief. I'm just saying, that's how they are. They will send people to you that wants to steal from you. They don't care if you live out in the streets and ice cold, sleep under a bridge. They ain't about to fix nothing. They're about to take everything you own and leave you out in the cold and die. Yeah, I'm about to sue the city. Because the tow company, I had already contacted them, told them they are not allowed on my property, and that the RV was there was nothing wrong with the RV. And the tow guy was like, "Well, the health department." I said, "No, that don't have nothing to do with you towing it." He said, "Well, the building commissioner." I said, "No, he's not allowed to take anything off of my private property without contacting me first. You don't take somebody's property without, finding out if the issue has been fixed, or if what is going on, because I have the paperwork that would, keep them from doing anything to me." But nobody contacted me, and the tow company lady at the desk said, "Oh, well, we don't do that." And I said, "Oh, well, you'll pay for that if you don't do that, because I asked you to do that. I gave you my phone number, and you knew better. You knew they didn't have the right to tow it. You knew it." So that's a lawsuit for the city. So I'll be filing my lawsuit this month. They just want me to sue them. Every penny that I've paid out, they will pay back three times, because they meant to kill me and shove me out into a prostitution ring. They knew better, too. They didn't have the right to do it. That's the whole point. is that they meant to kill me, and they knew they didn't have the right to take my property, my valuable, that's insured. You know what I mean?